Moyles likes to listen to the Friday Night Thingamabob to get new ideas for his show. Because let's face it, the Friday Night Thingamabob is a lot better than the Chris Moyles show.
Yeah, you wish.
Yeah.
Just gonna love you.
Fraser Cosgrove says hi, guys, and he loves us apparently. And Toto,
hello, Fraser.
I love you too, Fraser.
Fraser.
Anyway, so are we doing these answers now?
Okay. Well, have you got your sheets ready with the answers on?
Yes, we do.
Well, so hang on.
Question number one was: what was the first ever program to appear on Channel 4 and is still currently running? Answer is Countdown.
Yeah, I got that.
Well done, Tom. Well done, Susanna. Mr. Crossan, did you get that right? Well done, Mr. Crossan.
I hear about the hooves.
Okay, another one. This number two was: which duo foiled master criminal Feathers McGraw?
What did
now,
you put,
Feathers
Susanna?
McGraw.
I put Bill and Ben.
Bill and Ben. Tom.
I put the Wright brothers.
Okay. Okay. Well, I tell you, Feathers McGraw is a penguin.
And they invent the plane.
Yeah. Look, as soon as I saw the answer that Ross Angus gave. Hi, Ross. As soon as he gave the answer saying Wallace and Gromit, I was like, oh, why didn't I get that? That's so obvious.
Why did you put the right
Wallace and Gromit
Bell and Ben's better than that.
I know. Oh, my God.
Okay, so no one got that right. Question three. What, in population terms, is the largest Spanish-speaking country in the world? The answer is...
I put Mexico.
Oh, well done. Yeah. All round Mexico.
Thank you. Not Portuguese.
Yes, exactly. That was a trick question. In Brazil, they speak Portuguese. Well done, Mr. Crofton. Okay, question four. What is the world's most popular non-alcoholic drink? Susanna, what did you put?
Water. But it is water.
I put Coca-Cola.
I put orange juice.
The answer was coffee.
No, but Sean, water goes in the coffee.
Well, it's
no, don't give Susanna that.
What goes in the Coca-Cola?
And what goes in orange
Shona,
juice?
You are rubbish at questions. No,
yes, Shona. What is what
no,
you on?
No, it is water.
The answer is coffee, I'm afraid. No,
can I have
no
half
points.
A point?
The answer Shona. Is coffee.
Shona, can I have a point?
No, none.
Oh, Shona.
Because it's coffee, it's not water.
Shona. Shona.
Naomi's my favourite sister. Just kidding,
carry on. I'm totally offended. You're minus 2 points already. Okay. Question five. What's the closest planet to Earth? What did you put, Susanna? Jupiter?
I put Mercury.
Mercury, Mr. Crossan?
Mars.
Well done, Mr. Crossan. Mars is the
closest. Bummer, I got the wrong M.
I'm bummer! Tom, did you use a little M?
You got the wrong M?
Yeah, because there's a thing, you know, Mercury and Mars. Wait, what did you say? The closest to Earth? Oh, but I was thinking the closest to the Sun.
Oh.
Mercury is the closest to the Sun, though, right?
You are correct.
Yeah, okay, well.
The way I do remember it is my very excellent mother just served us nice pizza, so it's like my...
Mr. Cosmo thought something weird like that, except it's... Never mind, I don't even know one of them. Right, carry on.
Okay.
If I'd listened, if you'd... Oh, well.
Okay, question number six. Name all four members.
There's Joel.
Well, he's not listening to the show.
Okay, never mind. Continue.
Not getting my love.
Name all four members of GLS.
Astin, Marvin, JV, Orishe.
Correct.
Oh, well, I put Marvin. Is that his? Oh, look.
Austin.
But Austin. You know what I meant. And JB and Ortiz, but
I think we should
Ortiz, Austin, Marvin, and JB.
What's that?
Ross was kind of right, except he put Jonathan and it's JB.
It
is Jonathan something, but he's called JB.
Can I get that?
You can get that.
Yeah. He put Austin.
Look,
I'm having water.
No, don't have water.
Right, Susanna, I'm the quiz master. You don't get water. Tom, you can get that because that is actually correct what you've written.
Okay,
you just kind of spelt it wrong, but you can pronounce it.
Thank
okay,
you.
Next one, the maths question.
I didn't get
Mr. Crossan
got. But I got that wrong straight away, let's just say that.
What is 64 times 14?
896.
No, but that's not what you put.
Correct, she did put 896.
Oh, she got there in about half an hour.
Half an hour it took her. 896. Tom, what did you put?
I put nothing. I just got up to the
zero.
I got up to the bit where you times it by 10, but I didn't times it by 4.
Okay.
So I got 614.
Okay, that's wrong.
Obviously.
Sorry. Okay, question number eight is a topic that's been on the news a lot recently.
I put Scotland.
Okay, where are the 2010 Commonwealth Games being held? Scotland, what did you put, Susanna? Mr. Crossan.
Delhi.
Correct.
What? What is it?
What is it? Delhi, in India, is the correct
delicatessen. And the co-op delicatessen Commonwealth Games be there.
Wait, hold on. What was the answer?
Delicatessen.
Delhi?
In India.
Oh.
Delicatessen.
Wasn't there all these things?
That's 2014 Commonwealth Games being held in Glasgow.
Oh.
How is that different from the Olympics?
Because it's only the Commonwealth. Olympics is every
the
country.
Whole world.
Oh, okay.
Commonwealth?
It's the countries that used to be part of the British Empire.
Well, that's a bit... That's
and
a bit...
It used to be.
Aligned to Britain.
It's not very nice to the other countries. What do they want to join in? bit racist.
They don't get to, because they're not in the Commonwealth.
What?
Well, they should
get
into the Commonwealth.
Next one, anyway, moving on. You got that wrong, you got that wrong, Mr.
I got it right.
Well, I kind of got it right, I think it's 2014.
It's not Scotland, okay, whatever. It's 2010, okay, whatever. Not 2014. Okay, number nine.
That's this year.
What is the name of the new Harry Potter film to be released
in November? Deathly
Hallows. Correct. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows,
Logan
part
right.
one.
Well, yeah.
Go ahead, but I'll give you that.
Yeah, okay, thanks.
It's in two parts.
It's in two parts. What is?
The final new film. Not that I'll be watching it, because
really?
I don't like Harry Potter.
Two parts film?
Because the book's so big.
The Friday Night Thingamabob with Tom and Suzanne.
It's me, the insanely annoying, very handsome, and amazingly American voice from the Friday Night Thingamabob with Tom and Susanna. I'm afraid to tell you that nobody managed to record the last part of the Friday Night Thingamabob with Tom and Susanna, which included an improvised song about the school canteen. Lizzie would be proud.
You've just been listening to the Friday Night Thingamabob with Tom Holden and Susanna Angus. Be back next week for some more songs, games,
and Jamie Colville.
The Friday night thingy, my bop, the Friday night thingy, my bop, the Friday night thingy, my bop, Friday night thingy, my bop.
The Friday night thingamabob, next week, 6 till 8 on Argyle FM.